How's everybody doing? I didn't hear much from here.
Ow!
Now you're talking. I'm here to talk about harm reduction. Does anyone know about harm reduction?
Yes.
Well, the harm reduction I want to talk about, hey Nikichi, how you doing? Is reducing the harm of the prison industrial complex on our families, on our communities. More than 2.7 million children in the U.S. have a parent in prison. We all know that, right?
Yeah.
1 in 9 African-American children, 1 in 28 Latino children, and 1 in 57 white children have a parent behind bars. Parental incarceration increases the risk of children of living in poverty and experiencing household instability. Some assume that the removal of the bad parent, the criminal parent, will improve the situation for the child. But fact, parental incarceration more often intensifies, compounds, rather than alleviates the challenges a child faces. We need to reduce, alleviate the harm that the criminal justice system has on our families, on our children. And guess what? There are examples. The U.S. government is not paying attention. But in Australia, a court sentencing a federal offender must take into account the probable effect that a sentence will have on an offender's family or dependents. The judge must consider at least 3 factors. If the incarceration of a parent leaves the children without parental care, if a dependent will suffer overwhelming hardship because of the loved one's incarceration, and where the offender provides the only means of support. The court, judges, may suspend the sentence of incarceration, or they can shorten it. The Australian government recognizes that the rights of every other player in the criminal justice system are protected, except those of children. While some might argue that parental criminal law matters are not matters directly affecting or related to children, the wording of the United Nations Convention on the Rights of the Children states any judicial and administrative proceeding affecting the child must consider the best interest of the child. We are failing miserably in this country. But there is hope because there are folks in New York, in Arkansas, Osborne Association in New York, the Arkansas Voices of Children are leading the way and trying to make sure that there's a family impact statement at sentencing so that the voices of children are being heard.
Ow.
Families are being heard.
Ow.
And it is time for the U.S. to take a look abroad and at home in our different states to make sure that the women who are behind bars are being supported. There is a way, and we need to reduce the harm of the prison industrial complex. Not just drugs, but the prison industrial complex has got to go.
Yes, yes.